going?
It's going fantastic.
Fantastic. Hey, kids, we're so glad you're here. Thanks for joining us on Kids Church Online. It's so great to have you here.
Yeah.
Hey, I wonder if you've been getting ready for Christmas.
Yeah, have you guys been?
Oh, I hope you've been having a lot of fun. You know, I can hardly even believe it. I mean, it's almost here. Christmas is almost here.
I love Christmas. I can't wait. We just put up our tree and all of my favorite decorations. And I helped my dad put up the lights in the house, and I even got to put up the star on top of the tree. My dad had to lift me up super high. It was really a little scary, but I did it. And today we are making cookies. I love Christmas cookies and hot cocoa and Christmas movies and being with my family. And it really is my favorite time of year.
That's amazing, Merk. I mean, I agree with you. It's my favorite time of year. I mean, look, we've decorated here in Kids Church. Oh, it really is the best. Oh, Are you keeping track of how many days are left until Christmas?
19 days. I can count it on my fingers and my toes now. It's almost here.
Wow. You know, that is really soon. 19 days. Oh, well, what do you still need to do to get ready for Christmas?
Well, I still need to get presents for my sister and wrap all the presents and then make the cookies, of course. And and my family is making Christmas ornaments and for our friends and going up to the mountain and playing in the snow and writing a letter to Santa.
Wow, I love all those things. You know, Christmas is so much fun, isn't it? Oh, I love the food. I love the music. Oh, I love the presents. Look, I even have a couple here today. But I really love the lights.
I love the lights too. And my favorites are the lights that are here at the church. And me and my family came down last night. I'm just so excited because we got to see them all, and we were dancing, and the music and the lights they dance too. Oh. And they flash and they blink to the music. It was so much fun. We should invite the kids to come and see the Christmas light show.
Well, that's a great idea, Mark. Kids, you really should come down and see the lights out here. It's so much fun. The lights kind of blink and flash right to the music. Oh, and you know what my kids love to do? They love to dance in the parking lot or just listen in the car. Oh, it really is so much fun.
Ooh, and send us your pictures of your decorations or things that you are doing to celebrate Christmas. I want to see what everyone is up to.
Well, that's a great idea too, Mark. Oh man, we love getting emails from the kids or even messages on Facebook.
Oh yeah!
But you know what time it is now, don't you?
Time for worship!
That's right, Kids Church Online, we're gonna worship together and we have a new memory verse too.
Ooh, I'm ready!
Hey kids, would you stand up on your feet and let's memorize a new verse together and worship God together too.
Let's do it!
Okay. We're gonna be memorizing Psalm 51:10.
51:10.
That's what we're memorizing today.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay. Point up to God.
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 Create.
Create.
A pure heart.
A pure heart.
In me.
In me.
Give me.
Give me.
A new spirit.
A new spirit.
That is faithful.
That's faithful.
To you.
To you.
And we say, what should we do? A little psalm.
Psalm. Like you're going fast.
Psalm.
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 51.
10.
10.
One more time?
One more time.
From the top.
From the top.
You know, kids, if you memorize God's word and send us a video, we'll send a prize to you.
Yeah.
We love it when we get mail from the kids. So try it out. Send us a video. We'll send you a prize. It's lots of fun.
So much fun.
And we're talking about God, who we want to create a pure heart in us, right?
Yeah.
All right, so let's memorize it. Here we go, from top.
Okay.
God.
God.
Create in me.
In me.
I did that wrong. God.
God.
Create a pure heart.
Ooh. Create a pure heart.
In me.
In me.
That's right. Give me.
Give me.
A new spirit.
A new spirit.
That is faithful.
That is faithful.
To you.
To you.
Psalm.
Psalm.
51:10.
51:10.
Nice job.
Woo. Thank you.
Woohoo. Are you ready to worship?
Ready.
Should we sing a Christmas song?
Can we?
Let's sing some Christmas
yeah!
music. Worship God.
Let's do it. We're gonna dance.
season that he's given us a gift so great. It's Christmas time, yeah, it's Christmas time. He's the light of the world, come down to us. From heaven, now everyone sings. A gift so great. It's Christmas time. Yeah, it's Christmas time. He's the light of the world. Come down to us. From heaven, now everyone sing. We're gonna dance, lift our hands, celebrate. It's Christmas. Light up the world. Jesus is born. Raise your voice, make some noise. It's Christmas. Let's celebrate and shout for joy.
All the people, I just wanna be a sheep, bow, 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 bow. I just wanna be a sheep, bow, 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 bow. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, bow, 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 bow. I just wanna be a sheep, bow, 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 bow. I just wanna be a sheep, bow, 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 bow. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, bow, 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 bow. I don't wanna be a Pharisee.
No way.
I don't wanna be a Pharisee.
No way.
Cause they're not there, you see. I don't wanna be a Pharisee. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. Oh, I don't wanna be a hypocrite.
No way.
Oh, I don't wanna be a hypocrite.
No way.
Cause they're not hip with it. I don't wanna be a hypocrite. Cause I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I just wanna be a sheep. Bah, 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 bah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep. Bah, 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 bah. Well, I don't wanna be a Sadducee. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I just wanna be a sheep, bah, 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 bah. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep. Bah, 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 bah.
Hey, Merc!
Yeah?
Did you know that sometimes Christmas is called the season of light?
Is that why we put lights outside and all over the tree? I always wondered about that.
Well, not exactly. I mean, a super duper long time ago, it was actually candles that were used, and they used them as a way to welcome Mary and Joseph. And some people say now that the red and green lights, those colors at Christmas time, they actually represent the blood of Jesus that would be shed for us, and that we live for Jesus now and have eternal life with him forever.
Oh, so red would represent Jesus dying on the cross, and green would represent our life with him.
Exactly. But we still call it the season of light because, well, Jesus is actually known, and the Bible even calls him the light of the world. And during Christmas time, we celebrate his birth. And light, well, light is what destroys darkness, right? And when Jesus was born, it's like he destroyed the darkness of sin.
Ooh, we celebrate the season of light because Jesus is the light.
That's right. And you know, for the next 4 weeks during our Light It Up series, we're going to shed some light on the amazing story of Jesus' birth.
Oh, this really is my favorite time of year.
Me too. And today, we're actually going to start by talking about the very beginning of the New Testament. You know, we've been learning so much in the Old Testament, but you know, after the Israelites finally returned to Jerusalem, at the end of the Old Testament, well, 400 years went by before the start of the New Testament.
What?
Mm-hmm.
400 yep. years? That's a long, 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 long time.
I know. And after all that time, God sent a message to a guy named Zechariah.
I bet it was an important message.
Mm-hmm.
Did God tell him all about Jesus and that he was coming and that he would be really important news?
Well, God did tell him about a baby, but not Jesus. God told Zechariah about a different baby, one that Zechariah and his wife Elizabeth were going to have. And you know what they did?
What?
They cried.
Why? Weren't they happy? And what does this have to do with Christmas time? I'm so confused!
Well, they cried tears of joy, Merc, because they had really wanted to have children, but Elizabeth hadn't been able to have the baby. And they were super duper, duper, duper old. So they thought having children was like not even possible anymore.
Okay, but what does this have to do with Christmas? I mean, I'm sure they were happy and all, but 400 years have gone by, and this is the message that God delivers? I mean, that some other guy and his wife are gonna have a baby?
Well, the important thing about this is timing. They did wait a long time, but it was the perfect time because their baby was going to be a part of the Christmas story. This baby was Jesus' cousin, and later he would be a messenger for Jesus. God had big plans for his life.
Okay, I guess that makes sense.
But there is a super interesting part of the story too, Merc.
What's that?
Well, there was actually an angel that came to tell Zachariah that Elizabeth was going to have a baby, but Zachariah was surprised. At first, he questioned the angel. He said, "How can this be?" He said, "I'm too old. My wife is too old. Is this even possible?" So God made something happen. He made it so that Zachariah couldn't talk anymore.
What? That's so strange. Why did he do that?
Well, because he doubted God's power to do what the angel was telling him. He wasn't able to speak again for a very long time. For the whole time that Elizabeth was pregnant, over 9 months.
I can't even imagine that. I've tried to play the quiet game, and I lose every time. I don't think I could go without talking for more than a day, or even 5 minutes.
I agree with you, Merc, but Zachariah didn't have a choice. You know, I bet he learned how to communicate with his hands, but I'm sure it was super duper hard. I mean, it was almost like he even had to keep a secret for those 9 months because the angel had even told him what God wanted him to name the baby, but he couldn't tell anyone.
Oh man, poor Zachariah. I bet he learned his lesson though.
I think that was the point, Merc. He spent all that time learning to trust God's power and that his word is true. And when the baby was born, while everyone was suggesting what the baby's name should be, that's when everyone became surprised by Zachariah's response.
But he couldn't speak. What did he do?
Well, he demonstrated his trust in God. Well, he took out something to write on, and he wrote on the paper, "His name shall be John." And then God's spirit filled Zachariah so he could speak again. But the people were very surprised because everyone thought he would name his son after him, like little Zachariah Jr. You know, that would have been super common back then.
But the angel had told him a different name.
Yep. And Zachariah had learned to trust God's plan. This was the very first opportunity for him to show it.
But why did God pick the name John?
Well, do you happen to know what the name John actually means?
Like the bathroom. My grandpa always says he has to go to the John when he needs to use the bathroom.
Oh, Merc, ew. No. God often used names for people when he had great meaning for them. And the name John, it actually means God is gracious.
Well, that's way better than the bathroom.
Well, I agree.
But what does gracious mean anyways?
Well, that's a great question. Gracious means to show kindness.
So John's name means God is gracious, that God is showing kindness? Why is that a special name for him?
Well, that's a good question too, Merc. Well, it was a reminder to them that God was gracious to them. Remember, he was showing kindness to them because, well, they wanted to have a baby and they couldn't, remember? And God made it happen even though it seemed impossible.
Because we know that God can do the impossible. We talk about that all the time in kids' church.
Exactly. And someday, John would actually show the world what it means as well, because he would be the person to start pointing people to Jesus. Oh, and helping them to see that Jesus had come to be the Savior of the world. God's grace, through Jesus, showing his kindness to us.
Wow, John was the perfect name for him.
Exactly. You know, that's even what our Bible verse is about today. Shall we read it with the kids together?
Yeah.
Okay, kids, if you have your Bibles, you can open to Psalm 145, verse 8. That's what we're going to read together. You ready to read it with me?
Yeah.
The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger, and rich in love.
Psalms 145, 8. Exactly. Nice work with me, Merc.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. You know, God could have been mad at Zechariah because he didn't trust him. But because God is gracious and slow to be angry, just like the verse says, he gave Zechariah an incredible gift that he didn't even deserve. I wonder if that's ever happened to you or to you, kids. I mean, have you ever been given a gift that you didn't deserve?
Yeah, last year for Christmas, I got a VR, and I didn't expect to get one because I know how expensive they are. My mom knew I wanted one, but she told me that they were way too expensive. So when I opened my present, I cried because I was so excited. And my mom told me that all our relatives had each given a little bit of money so that I could have it. That made me feel so special.
Well, I love your example, Merc, because, well, Christmas is coming, and many of us, well, we'll be receiving gifts. Sometimes, I think we don't realize just how special those gifts are.
What do you mean?
Well, do you ever disobey your parents?
Sometimes.
Do you ever do things that you know are wrong?
Yeah.
Okay, well, have you ever talked back to your parents or gotten really mad at them?
Yeah.
So, if your parents only gave you a Christmas gift, if you promised never to disobey them or do anything wrong, do you think you would be able to earn your Christmas gifts?
No way! That would be impossible!
Exactly. That's the point. We receive gifts even though we might not exactly earn them or deserve them. You know, we get gifts because our parents and grandparents and friends and family, well, they love us, even though we mess up sometimes. That's called grace. And it's the same way with God.
He gives us gifts even though we don't deserve them.
Exactly. And we're given the gift of eternal life from Jesus, even though we sin and mess up and don't really deserve it. I mean, that's the greatest news, is that we don't have to earn God's love. We don't have to do anything to earn eternal life because it's a gift. A gift for all who believe in him.
I know the verse, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus.
You got it. A gift, even though we mess up. That's called grace too, right? Because of God's grace and mercy, he forgives our sins so that we can have eternal life.
Best gift ever!
That's the good news of Christmas. We celebrate that Jesus was born, that he is the best gift ever, a gift that brings us joy, knowing that he came to give his life for us.
So that we can be a part of the family of God and go to heaven where we can be with him forever.
Amen. And I say, let's celebrate this gift all season long. Ooh, and remember the true gift of Jesus as we open our presents on Christmas.
Yeah, but what are those two gifts that you have just, they've just been sitting there? I mean, what are they for? And who are they for? Can I open them? Ooh, I'm just so curious. I can't help it.
Okay. Well, I did wrap these presents up. But I left a little room in there to show you something special that's inside. Let me turn this around, and I have to ask you this. First of all, do you remember what our theme is?
Something about light. Light it up!
Yep. And do you know what the theme is about?
Well, Jesus is the reason we celebrate Christmas. Oh yeah, Jesus is the light of the world.
Exactly. So these boxes show a fun way for us to remember that Jesus is the light. So when you say light it up this time, I'll show you what I mean. Are you ready?
Yeah. Light it up! Whoa, so cool!
And if you look in this first box, this is a picture of Zechariah. Remember, he couldn't speak until he had learned to trust God's plan. And down here, this is a picture of baby Jesus because, well, we're learning the parts of the story all month long, how he really is
the light of the world. Like my mom always says, Jesus is the reason for the season.
And the reason he came was to be the light for all the world to see, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hey, kids, you know, thanks for joining us. We're so glad you're here. We love spending this time with you. Shall we see him next week?
Yeah, see you next week.
All right, bye.
Bye.